Hello all, we're back in Diesel Railcar Simulator. The key in. But it's not just any Diesel Railcar Simulator. Let's get the engine started. This is Diesel Railcar Simulator post scenery update, which is pretty exciting. So this update. Where there's the guardsman. Let's get the show on the road. Big scenery update just dropped. It was available in the beta, but that was only for one of the routes, and it's now released, so all of the routes have been updated, and this is the North Landen route, so we just left Little Green and we're heading down to St. Paddings Cross. And it is looking spectacular. Set on the old class 112. Drop that down into third. Yeah, the game's looking really good. Warning system, and the trilling bell there tells us that this distant signal is clear, I think. Too much brake there. And drag us forwards to the end of the platform. the game now is looking pretty special. I'll have to remember what the hide UI key is. DRS has really just become one of, I mean it was already really good, but with the updated scenery it's just looking spectacular. I reckon it just places this as one of the better train simulators. It's actually, I mean it's just a great bit of simulation software, full stop. On time. There's all kinds of new details in the scenery. This new terraced housing. Crossing gates and all sorts. It's looking really good. Thank you. one of the other big aspects of this update is the updates to the scenery editor. So DRS comes with a built-in scenery editor for your own route creation. And I have not dabbled with it myself, but Lappy will put up a video on his YouTube channel demonstrating some of the features of it, and it looks really smart. Really clever way of doing it. I used to play a bit of Trains, a New Era, and when I say play, I mean I spent hours trying to build routes, and they never really got any completed to any satisfactory degree. I created some nice little vignettes and things like that, little scenes here and there, but it's just super difficult to fill out a route, because every single item has to be manually placed. So a town, even a small town, could take you days or weeks actually, whilst you individually hand place every house, every fence, every bloomin' shrub. It's just not really feasible, and I always thought to myself, if only somebody would develop a system that created some form of autogen that you could fill out routes with. Well, a lot of the scenery generation in DRS fits that, or kind of fits that description. You place down roads and you can very quickly create a village scene or a town scene. Forested areas the same, you put in. Ooh, are we turning? Oh, Jing's Griffins. Panic. What's going on here? I think I was supposed to be in 25 through that. I was. Good grief. Too busy yakking. Abbots Grove 723, we're a couple of minutes out. Yeah, it's got nice little industrial areas like this now. These are all new assets. Station coming up. We're staying on this line. When you see it like that, it's not high fidelity simulation, high fidelity landscapes out to the horizon, but you don't need it to be. This is one of the things I love about this game. It's just meeting all the traffic on the line. Bridge assets, all sorts. Excuse me, I'm just going to check. Oh, here's it. It's running straight through, I think he is. Oh, that's good. Right. Hold on. There we go. Turn neighbours off, we should be going soon. Yeah, the scenery's not super detailed out miles into the distance, or I mean not even particularly up close, but when you're travelling at a rate of knots in your diesel rail car, you don't need it to be super detailed. Performant. There's our AWS, so let's slow things down here. There's a, look at that's nice that. Ooh, that's a big train that. And we must be coming up on our final stop. Oh, that was nice. Some raids coming up, so we'll just creep up to these. And that's because this guy's coming out, that's why we've got the red. So we'll just wait for a green signal. Get our screeny. Do a bit better with that. We'll just wait here till our semaphore shifts. So they've still got a green on that, on this line down here. I wonder if someone else is coming up. Can't accelerate time whilst you're waiting at these signals. I think we'll just wait and see what happens. If it takes too long, I might cut to the action. Waiting for express empty up 4 to clear the line. Well, I've got a couple of minutes to get to St. Paddings Cross, we'll be running late. Wonder if that's the up 4 empty, could be. It's one of the real cool things about this game is the timetabling and the traffic on the line. Cause it doesn't necessarily, I mean, you could run the same route over and over again and you won't necessarily get the same result. Things can run a bit slow or fast and throw the timetable out a bit. Looks like he's waiting at a signal as well. This line that's joining in still has the green. Maybe we'll go and search, see what's going on. So this one's got the green. Is there somebody down here? Oh, nightmare. That's what we were waiting for. The old class of 03 struggling up the Bray. He's got a right rake of coaches for that thing. What the heck? How many is he pulling? Good grief. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 coaches. Now a proper transporter could tell you what coaches they are. British Rail maroon ones or something like that. Here she goes struggling past. Well, I'll cut to it, come up on the line. See you in a bit. Well, here's the offending article. I can't believe the signalman held us for that. Is an ambitious load. Alright, on you go, don't mind me. You've got a high priority rake of empty coaches there. The punters will no mind. It's quite majestic. Screeny of that, then I suppose what's we're betting. Come out onto our line as well. Flippin' heck. Well, it's just as well I brought a thermos of tea. Anyway, whilst we're waiting for the Class 03 to clear the line, we'll talk a bit about DRS. And it's, I think it's now reached a point of maturity where you could compare this directly with any of the other train simulators out there. And this would, I think, not only compete, but I think in a lot of cases just outright wipe the floor with them. It's a super high, I mean, it's a high fidelity simulator. It's pretty cool. It's got everything going for it. I don't think it gets as much attention as it deserves, but hopefully there'll be a bit of noise about it with the scenery update. He's been working on this steady now for, I don't know, a couple of years. Maybe a bit longer. Right, he's out my way. We're still waiting for him. So that semaphore's now changed to red. Should see some movement on our signals soonish. Unless one of these other lines has got priority. Because there's two other trains waiting in the wings. Well, we're well late. Yeah, should have been there at 7:33, it's now 7:40. Almost 7:42. See, here we go. If I need to skip ahead, I'll let you know, but it looks like he's starting up. Oh, and we've got the green, lovely. Passengers will be pleased we're underway again. Stopped, but it's actually still going. So that was our distant signal, is red. So it's coming to St. Paddings Cross. Lighting effects. Yourself down to 10 coming in here. Oh, look at the class 37. Lovely. I'll just roll down here. So yeah, thanks for joining me on the run from Little Green down to St Paddings Cross. Hope you've enjoyed it. So DRS, it's on sale at the minute. I think 30% off, so it's like $20 Aussie. Cheap as chips for an awesome simulator. And do yourself a favour and go and pick it up. Well, that was not my fault. Alright, let's see how we did. So no tutorial penalties. We did exceed the speed a few times. That was that corner where we went from 50 down to 30. That's another awkward speed change there. Look. Got me out. But otherwise, not three bad. And 75% energy. So, not too bad. Alright, thanks for watching. Cheers.